injector, reseal, along with the valley pan. So we're going to take off the intake manifold, get into the valley pan for the coarse oil separator, reseal all 10 injectors, Teflon seals, which seal the combustion chamber to the injector, and also the rail to injector, as well as the oil filter housing. There's an O-ring and a figure 8 O-ring that always end up leaking, and also the coarse oil separator. It's a stamped metal gasket, usually doesn't leak, but while we're in there, it's a $10 piece, so we're gonna change that out as well. So we got our 5.2 V10 BSM and an S8. Handy dandy master blaster, never used it before. I got 25 pounds of coarse walnut in here, see how it works. Ash vacuum with a fine filter, and all the tools that we're gonna need. Maybe a little overkill. Some duplicates. Let's see here. Things that are really necessary for working on the BSM engine is these super short T30s. I got this one from Easy Red originally. This is a gear wrench set made in China. I haven't used it yet, just got it, but I got this whole set just to get the Torx. So we'll see how those fare out, but these are really awesome. Put them on the end of a flexible gear end drive and get in some really nice tight areas, so we'll use that in a second. Got our FSI walnut shell adapter, vacuum port, media port, is made by a guy called Ford Prefect on Audi Zine. So before we get started, get your hydration station going. Here's my little gun that I made up. We'll see, it's got a little compression fitting. Oh, it's not even tight, it's not good. Yeah, that's supposed to be 9/16. Also, this is the kit you need for injector resealing. This is an OEM kit, T10133. There's also a nice aftermarket version for about $100. This one's about $270 if I'm not mistaken. But it's necessary. You have a little pilot, hammer, and a couple. This is a seal and what they call a calibration sleeve for the Teflon seal. So before we begin, I already did a couple small steps. I just disconnected these fuel lines to bleed them. But before you do anything else, pull relay 614 from the passenger rear fuse compartment. So this is a relay. There's two relays in there. Two or three, whatever. This one controls the fuel supply pumps. There's two, one per side. It's a saddle tank, feed it up to here. So when we bump the engine over to close the valves, it doesn't start spewing fuel everywhere. So take this out, verify, make sure this is the exact one. I might be lying, but open the door, turn the key on if you don't hear any fuel pump primes, and it should be fine. So these are disconnected. I'm gonna verify one more time just to make sure with the key. To make sure this is the right relay. Nothing. No fuel spilling. No fuel spilling, so we're good. Take these fuel pump lines off. We'll get to that in a second, but 14 millimeter, 17 millimeter. Get your pygmy gunner there. And then we'll start pulling beauty panels and get this off. I'm gonna pull this evap hose. Why they go flying. Take off the foul air hose. This connector's disintegrated. Thank you. vacuum line. Once you have the two bolts from back here, you just pull this off. Oh, there we go. Fuck. Ow. Normally these guys are attached to here, but somebody took them off already. They're free of wiring. Manifold is off. That's what the valves look like. Oh boy. These are reusable, but I always put new ones on. Might see. So as predicted, this is completely dry. This might be leaking a little bit on the back. A little juicy. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that is juicy, very, very juicy. Wow, wow, wow. All right, let's see how this walnut blaster works.